Okay, welcome back to another video, and today is a weird one. So I attempted to make my own workout video. So essentially the project was going to be for my PE class, but that didn't go to fruition because, as you can tell, it's 20 minutes long and I needed to be between 8 and 12. And I tried to cut some stuff out, but then it wouldn't have made any sense whatsoever. It probably still doesn't, leaving everything in it. But yeah, I just thought I would put it here. So what I did I did like two separate things. I recorded parts of it at my house where I found this really cool article, which I'm not like reading 100%. I edited it some of the part, took out some of the stuff I couldn't read, like some of the names of the muscle groups and stuff like that. And then also I sort of modified it because it was talking about how you can do a bench press or shoulder raises, and some of that stuff uses dumbbell or other equipment. And so I put in some stuff that doesn't require extra workout equipment, since like some people still want to be remote after we've been in this pandemic for a year. So I just sort of modify it that way. I also Googled some facts because the article didn't talk about what a hamstring pull was, and I looked at what that was. I found some facts about push-ups. I Googled those as well. So the article will be linked in the description below. And then the other half, I went to a gym. I recorded 30-second intervals of me doing these exercises. So if you want to do 30-second exercises of each one, you can do that. And I was wearing a mask the entire time. It's weird. It's right. They're like, oh, once you're in the gym, you can take your mask off because you're like breathing heavy and from working out. I'm like, no, I'll just keep it on. But I'm pretty sure some people are like, I mean, weird, but you know. Gotta do me. So, I was masked the whole time, so I wasn't spreading any germs while I was doing my jumping jacks. Speaking of which, my key was just rattling in my pocket, so that was disturbing. I did some squats, and it's gonna be informational, and, it can also give you a workout as well. So, hope you like the workout video. Yeah. Now cut to it in 3, 2, 1. Anyway, so this is my workout video. I hope you like it. But before we start, shake out, move around, get loose. I am currently doing arm circles to loosen up. And in this presentation, we'll be doing different exercises that target areas like the glutes, the chest, the hamstring, your upper arms, and other areas of the body like that. I hope you like it, my presentation, and you learn something from it, because it's going to be educational as well. And can that train go away outside of my window? Great, it can't. Okay, so now the exercising part. The first area we'll be targeting is the chest, and we'll be doing push-ups. A push-up uses almost every muscle in your body, particularly the chest muscle. Frequent push-ups increase your functional and core strength and prevent shoulder and back injuries. In one study, 66.4% of total body weight is lifted during a push-up. Now, some facts. A lady named Ashley Weber holds a number of push-up records for women. She did 829 push-ups in 30 minutes and 1,200 or 1,200 in 1 hour.
The push-up. Start.
Okay, I hope those were some fun push-ups. Now on to the glute, and we'll be doing squats. The gluteal muscles are a group of three muscles which makes up the buttocks. The gluteus maximus, the gluteus medius, and the gluteus minimus. The function of the muscle includes extension, adduction, and exterior rotation and internal rotation of the hips, the hip joints. A bunch of exercises can work your glutes, but studies show that the squat always come out on top. The most muscles activity in the gluteus maximus, the main muscles of the glute, occur during the squat, but only when testers went to 90 degrees or lower. This is because the deeper a squat is, the more muscle fiber it utilizes. However, when you're completing squats, you should only go as low as is comfortable for you.
Squat. Start. Has it been 30 seconds yet?
After doing squats, it's now time to work on abs, and for that we will be doing the bicycle maneuver. Let's be honest, people always talk about how they have strong abs and how they can get better abs, but for a long time, sit-ups were considered the best way to tone and strengthen your abs. However, research found that completing sit-ups alone would have little impact on toning your abs. Instead, use the bicycle maneuver to strengthen your core and to see an improvement in your abs. This exercise will strengthen your internal and external obliques, among other core muscles. An added benefit of this exercise is that it requires no extra equipment and therefore can be done anywhere. Now, to do this, you will lie on your back, I believe, and do like a bicycle motion. When I was doing it with my brother, he said I did it close enough, but it wasn't like 100%. So this is the one I'm the least sure I did correctly, but it is still a really good exercise.
Bicycle, start.
Okay, now it's time to work the back with pull-ups / plank. A great exercise to work your back is the pull-up. This exercise targets the muscles of the back. However, to the nature of the movement, other muscles such as the biceps and deltoid are also utilized in the pull-up. But since most people are at home and not at a gym, we will be doing the plank. A plank is also great exercise, and it helps your core. And for me, it takes a lot of concentration to hold the plank and not to drop to the floor. So, good luck.
Plank, start. I think I've noticed that my core and the rest of my body too.
Okay, so up next is the hamstring. And for that, we will be using a swish ball hamstring curl or a jumping jack. What is a hamstring? Your hamstring are the three muscles that run down the back of your thigh to your knee. And I cannot pronounce any of them. As a group, they are called the hamstring, and they help you bend your knee and extend your hips. A hamstring pull happens when one or more of your muscles gets stretched out too far and tears. Some of them can be mild with quick recovery time, while others may need surgery and crutches for weeks. But we do not have a swish ball, but not a lot of people do, so we'll be doing jumping jacks instead. They also involve your legs, and your hamstring is part of your legs, and it also gets your arms involved, so you work multiple body parts during this exercise. So we'll be doing jumping jacks.
Jack, start. I think I hit my keys.
Next up is the upper arms, and for that we will be doing tricep dips or mountain climbers. When it comes to upper arms, most people think about their biceps, which run along the front of the arm, but actually the triceps are the much bigger muscle, and working it will make the overall arm appearance of the arm firmer. One of the best exercises you can do to improve this muscle is triceps dips. This exercise can be completed at home with the aid of a stable chair or step. Doing tricep dips are a good way to improve your upper arm strength using only your own body weight. But I decided to go with another exercise that uses your whole body, mountain climbers. They are one of my favorite exercises from elementary school, and it also gets your whole body involved.
Start. Mountain climbers.
The next area we'll be targeting, we are going back to our leg to the thighs, and for that we'll be doing lunges. The lunge is an exercise that works a range of muscles alongside improving core strength and flexibility. The lunge is also extremely effective in improving your thighs. It is crucial that the correct technique is followed to reduce the risk of injuries with this exercise. The lunge is also great because you can do it anywhere without any extra equipment. You can choose to do moving lunges where you go forward and back, or you can just do standing lunges where you just stand in one place. It does not matter. You will get the same workout either way.
Lunges start.
Now we are on to my personal favorite, where we'll be working the waist. It is the side bridge. I was very excited to find this exercise. I've never heard of it before until I read this article. To tighten the muscles and reduce the risk of back pain, the side bridge is a good exercise to complete. To do this exercise, you lie on your side with your weight resting on your arms so that your body is in a diagonal line with your upper leg directly on top of your lower leg. Then lift up your hips upwards so that your body is supported by the lower part of your leg and your arm. The side bridge will also improve your core and back muscles. If that was not a clear description, what you do is you are laying on the ground on your side, and your hips and the side of your body, I guess, is not touching the ground, and you're just on your forearms, and your legs is supporting your body weight off of the ground.
Hybrid start. Ten seconds.
Our second to last exercise, we will be working the shoulders, and for that it is the lateral shoulder raise, or sit-ups in this case. The shoulder muscles, the deltoid, consists of three divisions, east, central, and west. Oh wait, that's the baseball divisions. The divisions of the shoulders are the medial, the anterior, and the posterior. The posterior assists in exercise such as the seated row, while the anterior is active virtually every time the chest muscles are working, such as push-ups. The lateral shoulder raise is a good exercise to target the medial head alongside working the two muscles. Now that sounds great and all, but we can't do it because it involves outside equipment like dumbbells. Darn. So instead, we can do sit-ups. They still involve your shoulders in a way, and it is able to be done without any extra equipment necessary.
Start.
Two. Three.
4, that's enough, right? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And our final area we will be exercising is the hips, where options are the single leg squat or running. The single leg squat is a really good exercise, but I wanted to switch it up because we already did some squats earlier for our glutes. So I chose to do some running in place at the final exercise. It can help make your legs stronger, and also if you go outside for a run, it can help clear your head. I like running for fun because I enjoy it and I like challenging myself.
I'm gonna play start.
I hope you like this workout video. For a cool down suggestion, you can either do toe touches, or since you just finished running, you can slow it down and just simply walk. That is also a good way to cool down after an exercise. Another suggestion, you could do our burpees. Not for a cool down, but for a different spot in your workout. So I hope you were able to learn something with the facts I gave you, and I hope I was able to provide you with a good workout as well. And hopefully I get an A. Please? Pretty please? Okay.